Good day to you all. I want to start this video with some great news. I namely proved to myself that it is possible by putting half of the power over here as input, I can have the same result on the receiver output. And the circuit that I used to prove it to myself is this one. So we have 12 volts of the power supply, and I'm going to a switch. After that switch, I have a capacitor of 15,000 microfarad. Then we are going to the gate driver. Over here we have the single generator that gives us the pulses. And then we have the output of the gate driver going to a capacitor of 180 picofarad. And then going to the resonant kit coil as our transmitter. So that is the coil over there. Now, the resonant frequency of the two of the 180 picofarad capacitor and the resonance kit coil is 917 kHz. Now, I'm going to show you that the measurements that I have done. So, I'm using now the fifth harmonic. So, you can see every pulse we give, we have 5 free oscillations before we are coming to the next pulse. And that is, we are working with a frequency of 183.4 kHz. I'm going to show you measurements. So you see the peak-to-peak value of that sine wave is 326.28 volts. I'm now going to change the output on the single generator to the other channel. The other channel is set without free oscillations, so to the maximum frequency, but with a limited duty cycle. As you can see, it is only 5.8%, but that is done to become the same voltage as with the previous. So the peak to peak value is back again 328 volts, and that's why that we are not seeing any difference on the LED. So I will move back to the other circuit, the other output, excuse me. So that is channel 1, the low frequency with the free oscillations. And that is channel 2. In the previous video I made a zoom in, so I have proven to myself and hopefully also to you, and hope that you are doing the same experiments, that you can see it for yourself, because that is the only thing that will have a real value. So this is the situation that we are now having. If we look at the power supply, so this is with the free oscillations. We are using 0.14 watts and 0.012 amps. Over here on the PC screen, you see a transient recorder. What it does, it's measuring the voltage on the capacitor, and then you can put it in a graph. I will restart the recorder, so you can see over here there's a line running, and the moment when I switch off the switch, when on the blue line I switch it off, then you see we go down and we have a discharge of the capacitor. Now we are taking this line as a reference point to compare, so I will put it back on. I'm going to restart it. The moment that it is restarted, I'm going to switch off over here to see how long it takes for the line over here to come to the reference point. So we are there, we switch off, and you can see we are now reaching the reference point line. Going back on. So we can take the distance between those two. When we are using the free oscillations, is the time needed to discharge that capacitor into our transmitter and having an LED on the receiver. As you can see, we are still on the free oscillations. I'm now going to do exactly the same, but with no free oscillations. So I'm going back to channel 2 over there. Going back to the scope. Now you can see every pulse we have a sine wave, but we keep the 328 peak-to-peak fold. That is important, otherwise you are not going to get the results that I'm showing. Oh, excuse me. So as you can see, we have on channel 1, previous we had 183.4 kilohertz with a duty cycle of 10%. So to determine the duty cycle, you have to divide 50 by the free oscillations that you want. So in this case, we have 5 free oscillations. So we need to divide 50% duty cycle divided by 5, 10% duty cycle to have the correct value. Now it is not so easy to calculate over here, so this is more with measurements done. So we have the 917 kHz that our transmitter is resonant on. And when we use 50% duty cycle, we have 1.5 kilovolts output, but we want to limit it to the 328 volts that we have when we are using the free oscillations. So therefore, we need to change our duty cycle, in this case, to 5.8%. So that is the scope screen. Now we are going to look at the power supply. So now you see we are using 0.3 watts and 0.25 amps. Back to the transient recorder. So you can see these are the lines that we had with the free oscillations. I'm going to restart. And now I switch off. And you can clearly see the very difference when we are having the free oscillations or not. So what this setup proved to me is that we can have the same output on our receiver coil over here, but with inputting half of the power by using the free oscillations. And the more free oscillations you use, the better result you will have in the gain. But also, and I will zoom in, you have to take a look that there is a small dampening effect when we are, oh, excuse me, we have to change. There is a small dampening effect when we are using more than 5 free oscillations. But you can compensate that by using a Litz wire. But this video is to work with the resonance kit coil, because if other people have those coil also, then we know that we are having exact the same materials, or approximately, because every induction value is slightly different. Do I want to say something more? I'm going to show you some of the frequency measurements. So this is when we are looking at the sine waves. But Nick Denman, in one of his comments, was also talking about the frequency behind it. And that I'm also going to show you in the next part. So we have over here the input and the free oscillations. And I'm now going to use the mod function. And I'm going to use a fast Fourier transform. And you can see over here, now this frequency is around 100 MHz, and I'm not sure where it's coming from. That I have to find out. One moment, please. I'm going to use the cursor. I want to use it on the mod. And I want a frequency measurement. And I want E from the cursor. Move it to there. So over here you see that there is something at 148 megahertz. That is a spike. And at the moment I'm not sure where it's coming from. But that is not what I want to show you. I want to show you more on the lower frequencies. Have to look. Okay, there they are. So this is what we see in the frequency spectrum. So if we use our cursor back again and we go to there, then you can see at 936 kilohertz is this peak over here. Now we are inputting the 183.4 kilohertz over here. So if you multiply that by 5 from the 5 free oscillations, then you can see over here the peak that we have at 900 kilohertz. 900 over here it's 36, on the single generator is 917. There's a small difference, but keep in mind this is not a spectrum analyzer. This is just a math function used for it. So the accuracy will probably not be... this is just to show you and give you an idea on the other frequencies that are also available in the signal. So over here we have 752.9 kilohertz. If we multiply our base frequency that we put in, so the 183.4 kilohertz, and we multiply it by 4, then we are coming to this frequency. So if you look at the peaks, then it's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so on. So that is the part of each harmonic in the signal. Now, this is used on the mod function. I have to change back to the menu. So this is now used on channel 1. This is the output of our series LC circuit, so the high voltage. If we change to channel 2, then is that the signal that our gate driver puts into it. And there you can see that also the other frequencies are available, so the harmonics. But the spikes are very different from the other. So if we go back to channel 1, you can see, because this is our resonant frequency of the tank circuit, that we get that amplification of that specific frequency. So I hope this was also interesting to you. So thank you for watching and hope to see you in the next movie. I hope this will encourage you to experiment yourself. I have not done anything special. Just keep in mind that you need to have the voltage selected that is maximum possible with the free oscillations, and use that as a reference point, just as I have shown you in this video. I have certainly proved it to myself that it is possible. Hopefully you can prove it also to yourself, and I can only say it's really worth it. So thank you for watching and hope to see you in the next movie.